What a bunch of junk.
No green stuff here. Let's play, little human!
Hey, something's out there.
How do you find anything in here?
What? Who's there?
Someone died. There was nothing. Human.
Die!
our hands anyway.
That's it.
So, you're not an...
Hey.
Point the way.
Hey, Piper.
You know, I still really appreciate the fact that you're not an idiot.
Thanks, I guess.
No, I didn't mean like... I could just use some help. This isn't the sort of thing I'd normally bother anyone else with, but you just seem really good with people, and I've got this issue with my sister, Nat, becoming me.
Becoming you? What do you mean?
I'm just terrified she's gonna start taking up like her big sis. I mean, think about the life we lead. No offense intended, Blue, but personal safety doesn't exactly seem like either of our strong suits. I can't have her ending up like her big sister, dodging bullets and running from all the people she pisses off. It's part of the reason I'm on the road so much. Part of the reason I'm here with you. I keep thinking, maybe if I make myself scarce, if I'm not around her enough, she'll cool off. She'll just go back to being sweet, innocent Nat. Paper girl, an all-around upstanding citizen. What do I do, Blue?
You just love her. Family's precious. The last thing you want to do is drive them away, because you might lose them forever.
You're right. I can't risk that. Thanks, Blue. Who'd expect wandering off with a stranger to turn out this well? They really don't make them like you anymore. You're a hell of a friend, you know that?
Just friends, huh?
But a friend for life. Or at least as long as you don't start annoying me. But hey, thanks again for listening. It's a real weight off my chest to be able to talk it out with someone. So, you wanna hit the road?
Yes.
super mutants decorate this place? Part with anything, could they?
Wish a Buckethead would show up. I'd rip his legs clean off.
What was that?
they go? Heard of FEV? Apparently, it's what makes mutants so damn tough. Ugly.
Look at this place. You must hate these mutants.
Absolutely. Wiping them out was a pleasure.
I wish all of mankind shared your sentiment. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this madness. And just when I thought we were getting the upper hand, along come the synths. I've seen what these super mutants do to people. Can you imagine what the synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand? It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
Don't apologize. It reminds me why I'm doing this.
Thank you, sister. It's good to know you're taking my advice to heart. Anyway, that's enough of that. What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed. should head back to the Pridwin. I'll take care of the shells and the mess.
Guess they're not interested in sharing, huh?
Watch my back, I'll watch yours.
Ain't looking for trouble, I hope.
Hey.
You know what I call a good day? One that ends without an empty stomach.
Blue, can I get a minute? Something I need to do. How's it going? Piper Wright, Public Occurrences. So, are folks out here concerned with the Institute using synths to infiltrate the Commonwealth's food supply, possibly poisoning hundreds?
Gosh, I am now.
Oh, thank you for your time.
You better not cause any trouble.
Hi there.
Hello.
Iron Maiden's out to an early lead, but Beast of Junk's right behind. Atomic Dreams is still hanging in there. What a race! What a race!
Now this... this is funny.
It's another great day out here at the track.
Come on, hit him down!
Damn it!